Big Brother is over, now everybody can calm down from their adrenaline rush. And now we can have a conversation. Now, this is not, I repeat, this is not a video about who should have won or anything like that. Because I know people are going to come and start saying, hey, the person we don't win, make I go collect the money, give the other person, or start saying some dumb shit like that. No, that is not my point, okay? The winner is the winner. I just want to have a conversation. Now that I think a few people have calmed down. Now, I'm not a fan of Erica, or am I a fan of Leko, or even a fan of Big Brother, okay? Yeah, I'm not a fan of Big Brother. Now, before anybody tries to be smart, I'll come and say, if I'm not a fan, why am I watching or why am I talking about it? You can watch a football match of people that you are not their fans, or even a wrestling match of someone you don't even really like, okay? So that's kind of a dumb argument. Now, I just want to ask questions, okay? I hear a lot of people talking and saying whatever they want to say, and when I ask them questions, they can't really give me real answers, okay? They are giving some pretense or something that they think is an answer. So one of the questions I ask a lot of people when I hear them talking, I ask, what did Erica do that she got so much hate? Okay, some say the hate came because she rejected a poor boy for a rich boy, and some say they hate her because they knew her smile was fake and she was pretending from day one. Many claims is because she insulted Lekom, so that's why they all hate her. So let's look at each and every one of them and talk about them. So she said no to Lekom and everybody hated her for that. Okay. Did Nengi say no time and again publicly to Ozo? How come the internet did not break over that? You want to know why? Because most people have double standards, okay? So why is it okay for Nengi but not okay for Erica? Now see the part I really don't understand. Ozo got rejected by Nengi and tried to win her at all costs, okay? Well, you know when you say at all costs, it comes something really creepy. But let's just say he tried and continued trying and trying and trying and trying till he got kicked out of the house, okay? Erica rejected Lekom. Lekom said that she should give him space like this guy. He doesn't want to do anything with her. Then he went around and started badmouthing her. Now he was first her friend before all of that thing happened. Then he went around and started badmouthing her, and somehow you guys think he has more honor than Ozo. Ozo said that he loves Nengi and didn't leave her no matter what she said or did to him. But Lekom brought immunity between him and the woman he claims he loves. He started badmouthing her like one little bitch. And I'm not insulting here, okay? If you go around badmouthing someone because that person said no, and that person used to be a friend or used to be your friend, you're acting bitchy, okay? I still don't see how Ozo is the one getting the short end of the stick. There's no way you can convince me that Lekom has more honor than Ozo, okay? Because at that time he started badmouthing her, she was his friend. Somebody got to answer me that. Now, some of you guys say that she rejected a poor boy for a rich boy. Okay. Were you guys not the ones that say it looks like a thief, arm robber, Boko Haram, and some other messed up shit online? Many of you guys said terrible things about him, which means many of you guys out there would not want to do anything with him. Like, not even want to be his friend or even date him. Yet, when Nigerian social media and everyone out there were rejecting him, she was the one to accept him. Even with that, he still badmouthed her. Go back to most of these people that are typing, I dare you. Many of the people that are singing his praises now, many of them were the ones calling him name or even laughing about it. But now they are claiming to be the champions of the poor. So if you reject someone, it's okay. But if you reject someone because of a rich guy, it's bad. The one thing that Nigerians do, going for a rich guy, something that's an acceptable known factor, but when they see it in full HD, it's bad. Did I enter the Twilight Zone? Hello? Regina Daniels is praised for marrying a rich guy. They talk about her in any glamorous shit. But Erica is bad for doing something that's not even close to 2% of what Regina Daniels did. And now, lastly, because Erica insulted the hell out of him that night. Okay, Sisi, Tasha, Chloe. So you go tell me, say these three, they learn work for Erica place when it comes to insulting. Go. Erica's insulting no reach their own. And Erica had alcohol in her system at that time. Them CC are fully in control of their senses when they are insulting. And for some messed up reason, their own are okay. Look, I'm not saying what Erica did was right, okay? Heck, it was bad and it was wrong. But she was drunk. Now people are judging her for this one act that have alcohol involved. all of her past deeds are thrown out of the window,
nobody remembers them.
Let's not judge by all the good things, just the one bad. Let's not put her good and bad on a scale and weigh them. Let's just go with the one bad. How is any of that a fair judge? If you are still going to use this as a reason to say why she's a bad person, she was still drunk to some point. And if you are going to say, well, if your brain is light, you shouldn't drink, tell that to her dumbass boyfriend. Yes, I said it. You get your woman drunk, she start fucking up, that's your shit. You are supposed to handle that shit is all on you. And you're supposed to carry her out of there before she fucks up even more. Guys, now lie I talk. You never go party where you see say one guy bring him babe, come that party, she go drink, start a misbehave. He no carry her out. Don't be saying that all the time, he go carry the babe out. Yeah, I know some of you guys are going to come and start telling me, he get money past me. Yes, that is fact. And him not carrying her out as she start the fuck up for there is fact. Say him fuck up, okay? You know what? Let's even look at some people in the house. We can find reasons that we can kind of all agree that we have problem with these people, okay? Neo, now washing girlfriend's panties is a 50-50% argument in Nigeria, okay? Me personally, I don't think it's bad, but nobody wants to see that on national TV, okay? Now, thanks to you, it's not only saved in our minds, but the archives of the internet. Now, most guys cannot win the argument against that because you are living evidence of that. V is just a hateful sociopath, so I don't think I need to say more on her. Nengi is a confused twat that is drunk on her own ego. You rejected a man on national TV, even to the day he left, you still rejected him. And the next time you saw him, he didn't want to have anything to do with you, and you call him a fuckboy. Do you even know the meaning of a fuckboy? You were letting your friend Leko touch you inappropriately, let him see. Oh, and he saw it, and he didn't want anything to do with you, or he didn't want to talk to you, then you start crying and call him a fuckboy? You said you had a boyfriend or man friend to us all. Okay, that's cool. You forgot about all of that when you were throwing yourself to kid. Okay, not cool. Leko can touch you anyhow. Okay, that's weird. And now Ozo doesn't want to have anything to do with you. You make it a big case. Okay, that's stupid. Ozo, I'm not going to say you fucked up much, okay? Because many of us guys have been in that situation where you love and kind of chase that person that doesn't give a shit about your feelings. Forget all this masculinity you are seeing online. Many guys have been in that same boat, okay? But where you fucked up is doing all of that on national TV. But you got back a lot of your honor by showing the whole world truly who Nengi is. A little crybaby that cannot handle rejection. Lekom, now that is a case study that deserves a video of his own. The more layers I peel off you, the more I don't see what people are saying. Yes, you won. As one of the players of the game, you did a great job. But as a person, a human being, you are a horrible person. Erica told you she doesn't see you like that. You told your friend to give you space. I don't need to be talking again on how bad mouthing your friend is bad, but let's look at Ozo. What was your aim of dancing with Nengi like that for Ozo to see? You knew Ozo was crazy about her. You could have respected yourself. I mean, people all talk about that person's feelings, this person's feelings. You didn't give a shit about his feelings. But I have no doubt in my mind that you and Nengi's aim was to hurt him. Even though what you guys were doing annoyed him, he still manned up and looked away. But instead of you telling Nengi the truth, you are helping her remain in her delusion. Now, people are using you as a testimony. Some are saying, don't mock a man of grace because God will use that to insult him. It's funny how people can use grace and big brother in the same statement, but okay. There's nothing graceful about many things you did in that house, okay? You told Ebuka that she tried to kiss you multiple times with plenty of people around to hear you say that. Then you go behind and tell Big Brother that it was only once. You don't know where Ebuka or anybody else got that information from or that idea from. No shit, Sherlock. That night he just sat down there and kept quiet, and some of people are praising him like, yeah, that's what a man should have done. This guy, he did a good job. No, he didn't talk because he had nothing to say, okay? He was confronted head on by the truth and fact, and he couldn't say anything. That's why he just kept quiet there. But none of you guys saw that, did you? As I said, you deserve a video of your own. Erica, Erica, as one of the players of the game, you are a horrible player. You forgot about the main aim of the game. But as a person, as a human, you are a good person. If the world is going to call you a horrible person for insulting Leko and call you whatever they want to call you, then most of those people insulting you are horrible people too for just insulting him for his looks. You insulted him as somebody you knew who was talking bad about you. Large majority of these people insulted him just to get a few likes and shares. Look, stop trying to please people. It's you trying to please your boyfriend that got you drunk, and voila, here we are making a video. But lastly, I want to talk about people. Now, talking to people about all of this and the people that just say they hate her, I discovered a few things about these people. Now, 20% of these people just hate her for hating sake, and those ones are just horrible people. And look, I'm not insulting anybody, okay? If you can openly say you hate somebody for no reason at all, you are a horrible person. There's no argument there. Another 20% are saying they hate her because she rejected a poor boy because of a rich boy. Even if she did that, that's not why they hate her. They hate her because they did the same thing too when they met the same option in their lives. Many of them were dating the poor boy when the slightly better option showed up, and they jumped on that train. The key word here is slightly. They abandoned ship for the slightly better option guy. Then lastly, we have the 60%. They claim it's because of the insult she insulted Lekan. Half of those numbers are just emotional, so there's really no need for us to talk about them. And the other half saw somebody that stood up and will not take that shit from somebody they cared about. She wasn't going to take that lying down. She didn't cry about it, and it sickens them because they never did that when they had that option too. Many of them, when they met that option, all they did was cry and took it lying down. So they can't mentally process that there's an option to do what she did. That's just mostly where their hate comes from. So that is all, people. Those that just want to come and insult me, go ahead. This channel isn't new to insults. What's going to be funny about all of that is that you claim you hate somebody for insulting somebody, but you're going to have no problem with just right out insulting someone else. You are not really making any point if you are just going to be an outright hypocrite, but hey, you be you. And for those that want to have a conversation, yeah, let's have a conversation in the comment section. And those that want to answer me, please tell me, why does Erica get all the hits and why is she seen as a bad person? Anyway, that's all we have to talk on this topic. I'll catch you guys on the next video. Stay diamond, people.